Now, we have also learned that the mass of the nucleus can be written in terms of atomic mass unit. Okay, so we are talking about mass energy equivalence. So let me write it again. Okay, so we have till now we have been measuring the mass of atom or mass of the nucleus in terms of units U, or you can write down as AMU. Okay, so we don't measure mass of nucleus or atom in terms of kgs. It is units which we are using, which is 1/12 of C12 atom's mass. Okay, so if we are measuring the mass in terms of units, can we find out how much energy is released if one unit is converted into energy? Okay, how much is one unit? One unit is roughly equal to 1.67 into 10 raised to power minus 27 kgs. Okay, so quickly find out how much energy will be released if one unit gets converted into energy.
Yes, sir, so it's 14.2 to 10 to power negative 11 joules.
Now we are dealing with subatomic particles, so you have to find energy in electron volts. How many electron volts? Just divide that energy in with charge of an electron, you'll get in electron volts. So we are trying to find energy that is corresponding to one unit mass. If there is one unit of mass that get converted into energy, how much energy will be there? We have to use E is equal to mc square. This is 1.67 into 10 raised to power minus 27 into C square, that is 9 into 10 raised to power 16. Is somebody saying anything?
Yeah, so is it 9 into 10 to the power 8 electron volts?
Correct.
So I'm getting the same thing.
Okay. This, if I divide it with charge of an electron, which is 1.6 into 10 raised to power minus 19, I will get the energy in terms of electron volt. Fine. So just remember this value. This is very useful. Energy will be equal to 931.5 mega electron volt. Fine. So this is the energy corresponding to one unit. Okay. So if mass defect is 0.5 units, then how will you find energy corresponding to that? If mass defect is 0.5 units, then energy will be what?
So half.
Half of this. So this energy is corresponding to one unit. Fine. So if there is a mass defect of whatever number of units, you just have to multiply that with 931.5 MeV and you'll get the answer. Okay. So let us do a numerical on this. Write down, guys. You have to find out energy equivalent of this oxygen O16-8. This oxygen, you need to find its binding energy. Okay, what is given is this: the mass of oxygen is given as 15 point. You will be dealing with a lot of weird numbers, so be patient about it, you know, because these are easy marks. The concepts are very, very simple. Those who get frustrated, get irritated, will lose the marks, and there lie your chance to score over them. So this is mass of O16, one atom of oxygen, mass of the neutron is 1.00866 units, and mass of proton is 1.00727 units. Although the electron are immaterial, but then still, you know, the value of that, let me give here. You know, the mass of electron is very, very less compared to the mass of neutrons and protons. This, okay. Now you need to find binding energy of 16 oxygen 8. Do it. First step, just like you have to find, suppose, you know, bond energy in chemistry, you do what? You write a reaction, right? Similarly, here also, you first write down the reaction. Anybody got mass defect? First, tell me the value of mass defect. The reaction which we are talking about here.
So it's 0.1369.
Yes. Are you using calculator? Naman?
Yes, I'm not.
Good. That's quite accurate. So 8 neutrons and 8 protons. They give you a nucleus of 8 neutrons and 8 protons. So this is oxygen nucleus. Okay. So the mass defect is what? See, this is mass of atom given. It's not mass of nucleus that is given. You're getting it? So in order to find the binding energy, first, I mean, actually speaking, you need to first subtract the mass of all the electrons that are there. Although that is very less, but in order to maintain the correctness, this is the mass of oxygen nucleus. Okay. The mass defect is when you subtract this from 8 times mass of neutron, which is 00866, plus 8 into 1.00727. Okay, so this will come out to be equal to 0.13691. Aditya, you got it?
Sir, the final answer, 127.615 MeV.
Yes, correct. So the energy is what? For one unit, 931.5 MeV is the energy. So for 0.13691, it will be this multiplied by 931.5 MeV. Okay. This will be around 127.5 mega electron volt. This is the binding energy of the nucleus. Are you getting it?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So, can you find out? They just very similar numerical we are doing now. I mean, this chapter, you need to be comfortable with calculation. So I'm giving you another similar numerical. You need to find binding energy of the nitrogen. The mass of nitrogen atom is given as 14.0 0.0307 units. Okay, mass of neutron, proton, and electron, it is already given. So what is the binding energy of the nitrogen atom or a nitrogen nucleus, so to say?
So is it 0.975 into 10 to the power 8 electron volts?
So you're saying 9 MeV?
Yes.
Yeah, it is close to that. Others? What is the mass difference you are getting?
0.108.
All of you getting this mass defect?
Yes, sir.
That is 7 times mass of proton plus 7 times mass of neutron minus mass of 14.7 nitrogen. I am ignoring the mass of electron here. Okay. Fine, so once you get delta M, just multiply it with 931.5 MeV, you will get the answer. Fine, let us move to the next concept. Now, we have already got introduced to binding energy. We will discuss more about it. So binding energy, if it is more, it implies that the nucleus is more stable, more energy is released. Okay, but does it actually means, or does it actually give you a good indication of how stable the nucleus is? Because it's like this, you know, that if I tell you that one basket has 50 apples, other basket has 2 oranges, and if I ask you which one is heavier, like apple is heavy or orange is heavy, then you can't just find the weight of the entire basket and compare, isn't it? You have to take one unit of apple and one unit of orange and compare their masses. Fine. So similarly here also, if my intention here is to find out how stable is one proton or one neutron inside the nucleus, then the total binding energy is not the correct measure of it. Fine. I need to find out a binding energy which is corresponding to each proton or neutron here. It's like this, you know, that suppose there is a molecule that has multiple bonds. Okay, so if I want to find out the bond energy of one bond, then I should not take the bond energy of all the bonds, isn't it? So I need to find out the number of similar bonds divided by, I need to find out the total energy that is released when these bonds are getting formed divided by total number of these similar bonds. Fine, then only I can compare how strong the bond is. Similarly, here also, when the nucleus is getting formed, I can say that some sort of nuclear bond is getting created. Fine, so rather than measuring in an absolute manner, like the total amount of energy released, what I should do, I should find out how much energy is released per nucleon. What is nucleon? Nucleon means, write down, nucleons are the particles inside the nucleus. They are particles inside the nucleus. Okay. So what are the particles inside the nucleus? Neutron and proton. And neutron and proton, when you add it up, you will get mass number. Okay, so when you divide binding energy with mass number, you will get binding energy per nucleon. So binding energy per nucleon is a very good measure to compare the relative stability between the two nucleuses. Are all of you clear about it now?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so if I take different kinds of nucleuses and try to plot their binding energy, and if I have to compare it, I need to plot what? I need to plot binding energy per nucleon, okay, with atomic number. Okay, so let us say this is my x-axis, and let me draw my y-axis. Okay. Y-axis looks not so straight. Okay. So this is my y-axis, which is nothing but binding energy per nucleon. So BE divided by A. Okay, so this is measured in MeVs. This is MeV, and here on the x-axis we have mass number, let us say. Okay, so here the mass number will be 0, and then you'll get mass number of 25, then this is 50, then you'll get 100, 150, you get 200, and then you'll get 250. Okay, so like this, you have the scale on the y-axis for the mass number. On the y-axis, you have 2 MeV, you have here 4 MeV, then 6, and then you have 8 and 10. Okay, so when you plot the graph, although my graph is not to the scale, it is better plotted in your notebook, sorry, in your textbook. So I'll just draw roughly. This is the plot that is observed, okay? And it is observed that it will have a peak. It will have a peak at atomic number A, sorry, mass number A, which is 56. Okay, what is mass number 56? Which element it is? Any idea? No idea? This is iron. Okay, so iron nucleus is considered to be the most stable. Fine. Although the iron will take part in chemical reactions, but in chemical reaction, nucleus doesn't take part in it. Okay, it is the outermost shell electron that takes part in the reaction. The nucleus remains as it is, intact. Okay, so this is the stability of the nucleus that is plotted. This is, you can say, around here, it is uranium 239. 238, let us say. Okay, this is hydrogen, whose mass number is very less. Then here you can see the lithium. Now you can say here, you know, that when you go from hydrogen to helium, you can see there's a huge jump. This much jump is there, binding energy per nucleon. Okay, but when you have sufficient amount of nucleons, let us say from atomic number, let us say 30 till atomic, I'm again and again saying atomic number, it is actually the mass number, sorry for that. So if mass number is greater than 30 and less than 170, you can see that the binding energy per nucleon is remaining almost the same. There is not much of a variation there. Okay, so these are the few of the direct observations you can make from the graph. All right, so we'll first write down the observation which are there, then we will also try to derive some conclusions based on the observation. We'll try to see what can we infer from the observation. Okay, write down few of the observations. Binding energy, the first observation is binding energy is approximately of constant value for mass number between 30 and 170. Okay,